The bus has been a second home to the Roanoke College Maroons for the last month. Step off, unload, a familiar routine, and a lot of time together.
That bus was amazing. You know, we had guys taking turns sleeping and playing video games. So we stopped and watched a Cincinnati game, and you know, hopefully that'll be a dream of mine that I can make come true. So
we enjoy each other's company. I think that helps a lot. You know, it's a group of guys that really just truly enjoy being around each other.
14 hours, a time change, and nearly 900 miles have brought the Maroons to a destination unexpected a month ago.
It's an incredible group. We thought we had a chance in the fall. You get into postseason, anybody has a chance to win, and we've just gotten hot. If you would have seen us play the last back third of the season, you'd probably be shocked that we're here right now.
To get to its first Division III World Series, Roanoke College had to win seven straight. After dropping its opener in the ODAC tournament, that experience proved to be a great teacher.
I think there's almost a desperation you play with. There's a little more passion. Each pitch means a little bit more to you. And then the biggest thing we harp on is the free 90 feet, every error and walk. So if we can capitalize on those and minimize them on defense, that helps us out with our chance to win games.
To this time in the season, every pitch really can make a difference in the game. You know, one pitch here or there, you know, an error, or, you know, that extra 90 feet, you know, could really make a difference. So just try to focus as much as you can.
Roanoke starts its championship journey tomorrow at 2:15 against Oswego State, New York. In Appleton, Wisconsin, Patrick Reed, News 7 Sports. Roanoke College can add another bullet point to its 2017 resume. With an 8-7 win over Oswego State in the first game of the NCAA Division III Baseball Championships, the Maroons are in the winner's bracket. And in a season of firsts, it was about classic keys to baseball success today: two-out run scoring and shutdown relief pitching. The Maroons tied it at two in the second, and with two outs, Sean Guida takes one through the right side to put Roanoke up a run. Oswego had a four spot in the fourth to go back ahead, and it was 6-6 with two down in the sixth when senior Will Decker made just enough contact to bring in Guida. It was 7-6 Roanoke. Then freshman Sal Trancucci was lights out for the Maroons. 3 1/3, one run allowed. Oswego made it a one-run game of the ninth, but it was attitude that lifted Roanoke today.
A lot of teams that don't believe each other, don't have 10 seniors who have led us all year, probably went back on their heels and not handled it that very well, but we've been in that situation before all year.
The first come naturally almost for us. At this point, it's kind of, we're just here to get wins, whether it's the first one or the last one, we're just trying to win games.
Shutdown innings after you score, they're huge. They're momentum swingers. We got three in a row, four in a row with big fellow on the mound. He's been our rock all year.
Next up for the Maroons, it's winner's bracket play tomorrow at 2:15 p.m. against the Presidents of Washington and Jefferson. In Appleton, Wisconsin, Patrick Reed, WDBJ 7 Sports. After an 11-1 loss to Washington and Jefferson today at Fox City Stadium, Roanoke College finds itself on the brink of elimination at the NCAA Division III Baseball Championships. They had plenty of offense yesterday against Oswego State, 8 runs scored, but today the Maroons could only scratch out 2 hits against the Presidents. Now the setup was great. It may have been soggy in your hometown over the past week, but perfect today in central Wisconsin. And a good start for the Maroons, who struck first. A second inning sack fly for Drew McCullough made it 1-0 Roanoke. At this point yesterday, they trailed by 2. But Washington and Jefferson, they may be racing Presidents at Nationals Park, but they were hitting Presidents today at Fox City Stadium. 2 homers in the fourth sparked 11 unanswered runs. But Coach Matt McGuire says there's no reason for this group to be uncomfortable.
We'll bounce back. We've got 10 awesome seniors who've led us all year. We're loaded for bear. We've got plenty of arms to fight through this thing, and I think our resiliency and toughness will show tomorrow morning.
I mean, we've played with our backs against the wall all year, and we've done battle to adversity, and just keep playing our game, stick to our plan.
The Maroons need to win 2 tomorrow to stay alive, but rain might be a factor here in central Wisconsin. In Appleton, Patrick Reed, WDBJ 7 Sports.